After years of research and development, we've created an automatic, fully electric, electromagnetically accelerated projectile weapon based on the Halo MA5. This video is sponsored by Omaze. Enter at omaze.com/hacksmith for your chance to win $100,000 cash and support a great cause. When you think of futuristic warfare, and pretty much any science fiction movie, technology has advanced to the point where using any sort of black powder or explosive fuel seems downright silly and wasteful. From laser weapons to plasma to magnetically accelerated projectiles, the future is in pure renewable power. In fact, we've been messing around with sci-fi energy weaponry for years now. From Iron Man's plasma gauntlet to his repulsor, to Zarya's laser bazooka, to our various lightsabers. Though, the latest iteration still uses a type of fuel. But what if we had enough electricity in a small enough form factor to power pretty much anything? Turns out, we almost do. Years ago, Ian and I built an electromagnetic railgun as a science experiment, basically trying to recreate the ones used on Navy warships. It worked, but despite the giant 400-volt capacitors, it wasn't very impressive. Fast forward a few months, and while interviewing potential co-ops, we met Charles.
Why should we hire you? You start on Monday.
We basically hired him on the spot, and we started building our very first electromagnetically accelerated projectile weapon. Alas, due to Canadian laws, we had to make it less powerful than we had hoped, but all in all, it worked quite well. Though, it was only single shot. That wasn't enough for Charles, and he continued researching and planning version 2.0 for the next few years while he finished school. Today, he's a full-time employee here, and I decided it's about time to give him another shot. And since Halo Infinite just came out, and since we already did the Spartan helmet complete with a heads-up display and a real-life plasma energy sword, we might as well base our new energy weapon on the Halo MA5. Let's see what he can come up with.
Let me explain how this is going to work. We'll be using 13 electromagnetic coils, each to pull the projectile faster and faster as it moves down our barrel. Typically, each coil is only able to draw in a magnetic projectile towards its center. Electromagnets don't know that we only want the projectile to go in one direction. So we have to design the MA5 to turn our coils on, pull the projectile forwards, then turn the coil off before it starts to suck the projectile backwards again. That means each of the 13 stages requires controllers that determine when to turn the power on and off. Since this is happening at projectile speeds, we have to program the MA5 to sequence the coil stages automatically. To know where the projectile is, we have an LED and a light sensor at each stage. As a projectile interrupts the light beam, we want the controller to shut off the current coil and magnetize the next coil ahead. These need to be timed precisely, or the coils will instead slow the projectile down, make it shoot backwards, or possibly even catch fire. Now, you might be thinking, that sounds pretty simple. It isn't. In fact, this is the most complicated thing I have ever designed. So what makes it so difficult? You may remember, back in 2019, we did something an awful lot like this. That one was great, but it left a lot to be desired. It was crazy heavy, could only fire one shot at a time, needed an external battery pack, and it kept catching fire.
Uh-oh.
I've been thinking about how to make this better for the 2 years since. Here's where it gets hard. I only have to replace the batteries, busbars, controllers, coils, chassis, grips, switches, and software. Really, I have to replace everything. First, to get it to stop catching fire, I've got to redesign the switches to more reliably handle the 500 amps of current passing through them. This thing uses more power than our original lightsaber when you pull the trigger, and that was challenging last time. To redesign the switches, I of course used Altium Designer, the industry standard in printed circuit board design. Problem two, getting rid of the power purse. I want this thing to be powerful and portable. I need to find a way to fit powerful enough batteries in the chassis so I don't need to tote a tote into battle. Problem number three, I want to make it fire multiple shots without reloading. To do that, I'm going to have to design some sort of magazine into the back end. Finally, the weight issue won't go away in one fell swoop. The 2019 model was made out of 1/8-inch steel plate. I'm going to use aluminum and make it thinner. Also, the coils had to have a whole bunch of wraps of copper on them to produce the current, something that the batteries and switches could survive, which made them heavy. And we had to add an extra cosmetic wrap of copper on some of them, which made them even heavier. Since we have better switches and better batteries, we can use fewer turns of copper. And with the benefit of hindsight and having a big-ass lathe, I can just make them look pretty in the first place. Dialing in those smaller coils took some doing. I ran a crapload of magnetic simulations, balancing the weight against the risk of it melting into a puddle in my hands. We're gonna want exactly 8 meters of wire on each one of these coils. I've got this jig that we can put our mandrels in, and I've got these reels that are ready to go with 8 meters of wire that we cut off yesterday. So, what do you say? Let's go build some coils. This is really sketchy, so don't do it at home. Okay, now I just need to do that 12 more times. Coils are done. Now we just need a switch that can turn them on and off. This is a MOSFET, a metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. It can comfortably fit on the tip of my finger, and it can switch enough power to start your car. On each stage, we're gonna have two PCBs. If it's gonna be 13 stages, then I guess I need to solder up 26 PCBs. But before we do that, I have to test something. We're in the semiconductor shortage right now, and when I tried to order the part I actually wanted here, it was on back order until 2023. So I ordered some compromised parts, and we're gonna have to test those before we can actually make all 13 of these. I know I could calculate this out if I took a couple of days and simulated it, but it's probably a heck of a lot faster and far more entertaining if I just plug it in and see if it explodes. So let's do that.
To see the full schematic diagram, check out the project on maker.io. Link in the description below.
3, 2, 1. That's what I was afraid would happen. Apparently I've got some work to do. We'll sort that out and then solder up a bunch of circuit boards. Crap.
$100,000. Imagine what I could do with that. Yeah, that would be awesome. But what would you do with $100,000? Head over to omaze.com/hacksmith and enter for your chance to win. Omaze giveaways are one-of-a-kind prizes and experiences while donating money to chosen charities all across the world. $100,000 can be life-changing money. Maybe you could use it to fund your own Hacksmith-style project, or you could travel around the world, twice. You could buy your favorite dream car, or, you know, you could achieve whatever you want. Just by entering, you'll be helping Journey House, a charity that supports former foster and probation youth to live fully independent, successful lives. Founded in 1983, they provide emotional support and guidance, as well as financial aid to help with the cost of attending college and vocational schools. Your generosity will go to support former foster youth in obtaining their higher education. For your chance to win $100,000 and support Journey House, a great cause, go to omaze.com/hacksmith.
Let's assemble the barrel. Okay. Oh, Rhiannon.
What's happening?
Disaster averted. That would have been bad. That would have been so bad. I have the entire thing hooked up backwards. Every single one of these would have burst into flames.
Okay, we should be good to go now. Just need to plug the battery in.
All right, it's all ready to go. We just need something to shoot at and this cardboard box ought to get the job done. Just load that in right there. Oh man, I hope this works. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, well, something went wrong, but didn't go that wrong. Okay. So I just pulled off the battery connectors, and I see this little pockmark where it looks like there was just a bad connection in between the bus bar and the electrical terminal. That was the only problem, which I think it was, because nothing's on fire. I'm just gonna tighten the screws tighter this time. And that's all I can really think to do. Three,
two, one. Well, something's burned pretty good. Oh my God, that is vile. Okay, yeah, so this stage failed closed, which means that the magnet just stayed on, which means projectile just stayed there the entire time. Don't know why that would happen, so I need to take this back up to the lab and run a bit of a post-mortem. And then, once I've got that sorted out, the whole thing should be good to go. But there's just one little issue, and that's that I don't think I can feed these guys into the back of it fast enough for us to get what we want. So we're gonna need some sort of automatic feed. Yeah, we'll get to that next. We need a magazine. Here's one I prepared earlier. It's a box with a spring inside of it that shoves a bunch of projectiles upwards. Whenever we pull the trigger, the topmost projectile is gonna get shoved out of the magazine and into the back of the accelerator. I've got all the parts together that I need to assemble the core of the MA5. We have the accelerator, which I've gone and got anodized to change the outside color to black. We've got the battery pack, got a magazine, got the lower receiver frame, got the grip, the lower receiver side panels, the main controller, the power supply, and the upper receiver. Let's put it all together. A bit heavy. This is our battery pack, and blue just doesn't match the whole MA5 aesthetic. Now the secret ingredient, these three GenZace Redline lithium polymer high voltage batteries. The functional unit is ready and it looks fantastic, but it doesn't look Halo. Luckily, Tyler's gone and 3D printed us all these parts that will really sell the MA5 aesthetic. As an added bonus, Chelsea, who earlier made the heads-up display from Halo, made up this little module that we're going to mount inside of the display, and it's going to show us the round counter and our compass heading, just like in Halo. Here it is, the Halo MA5. With this, Chief is ready to take on the Banish. After weeks of hard work, it's finally ready to test. And who better to have test it than Master Chief himself? Come on, that ain't it, Chief. That ain't it. We just need to reload. Put it in from the backside with the filleted end towards the flat. No, that. Push it down, you put the thing in the hole, you push it. Can you believe that guy? Just from all the current that's running through these coils, because there's something like 400, 500 amps in there, and that's a heck of a lot of juice in a small space. So, we're just gonna help it out a bit. Magazine got stuck. We knew this would happen on one of them, I didn't check which serial number it was. Chief, I can't hit
from here. Let's get closer. Chief, I need another bag. Holy crap. All right, apparently gummy bears are beyond our destructive capabilities. Jammed. Okay, yeah, misfire. Hang on, and back over. Yeah, let's just bail it. All right, looks like it was just a magazine issue. We swapped that out, and now let's take on the Banished. Apparently, it wasn't just a magazine issue.
Yeah, that hasn't actually happened yet.
And that is what we call an anti-climax. All right, let's take another go at that. I was really expecting that to break. You might notice that this thing really isn't doing the kind of damage that the MA5 is capable of in Halo. Well, there are a few reasons for that. First, we live in Canada, where that would be illegal. We cannot construct anything that launches projectiles at over 152.4 meters per second and with kinetic energy over 5.7 joules, lest we get the Mounties beating down our front door. Second, there are fundamental limits to what this type of magnetic launcher can do. The 2019 model was brushing right up against them, but installing this tube for the barrel took three people and a rubber mallet, so I made the new barrel in segments, without the inner tube. Sadly, that means that there are gaps in the barrel, which the projectile is wasting energy bouncing off of and scraping against. We're seeing about 50% losses from that alone. Which brings me to my third point. Engineering is hard. Expecting ringing success on any first prototype is setting yourself up for disappointment. There are always issues to solve, avenues for improvement, and ways to make it better next time. But even though there are many ways I can improve on our MA5, it is still the coolest thing I have ever built, and I'm so glad you guys got to come along for the ride. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Visit Hacksmith.store for all the latest merch, and don't forget to check out Hacksmith Vlogs for more exclusive Hacksmith shenanigans. And to hear more about what goes into Hacksmith projects, become a channel member today to see our director's commentary series where we break it all down for you. I'll see you next time.